Okay, so today I'm going to do a Helix Nebula, attempt to do a Helix Nebula as an acrylic pour. But first, I'll let you know how I prepped everything. First, I took a record and found some Kraft black paint. I will look up the information of what brand it was again. I don't have it right here, but I painted the whole record, including the label. Then let it dry overnight. Then I covered the back with tape, some painter's tape, and now I am making some light blue to create some stars for some of the background to sit here, and then I will let that dry. And then I will be start my pour with some of the stuff I mixed here. I've mixed some red for the center. I don't know if you can see that. It's a red combination of some deep cadmium red hue, Liquitex Basics, and then also some heavy body quinacridone crimson in this mix, and some pouring mediums and some Flowade and some water mixed in to because the acrylic heavy duty is a little bit thicker. Then I made up a batch of a turquoise color, and that was made with some Liquitex Basics bright aqua green, some deep green, some phthalo blue, and mixed all together, and I came up with that pretty color. And the last one I'm using for the outer part of the nebula is the Lumiere Pearl Emerald Green color, and that's mainly just that color and some of the pouring medium, and that's what that one looks like. I've used that before in a previous video. And now I'm just making some light blue colors for my stars that'll kind of be spread throughout the galaxy. So now I'm gonna attempt to make a couple stars here and there scattered. Some will just be points, some will have actually the little crosshairs in them. Not too steady at this, doing it from a distance. Oh boy. Not turning out the way I wanted to. So maybe I will not do that many that way and just do a couple points here and there. I mean, I could splatter, but I think I'm just gonna put a couple spots on here and there. Okay, so attempts at making stars not so successful. We'll see what it looks like underneath of my acrylic pour. I'm just gonna play. There we go. And now I'm gonna let it dry here. Maybe even heat it up a little bit with a hairdryer. So I'm gonna turn off the sound here and look for my hairdryer. Oh, nope, I found it, but I'll turn off the sound anyway. Okay, I'm back. So now I'm going to, oops, clean my brush a little bit. And now attempt to do a pour here. Hopefully everything's dry enough. So I will start with the outside, which is going to be clear because it's going to be mainly a black background for the most part. So anyway, so I got this record on a Lazy Susan. Got this record on Lazy Susan, and hopefully probably should get an apron on before I start spinning this stuff. Now I'm just spreading around the clear pouring medium onto the outer edge of this nebula. And maybe I'll even show you the reference photo for my inspiration here in a little bit. But for now, just getting a little bit of this clear stuff on the outer edge. And then drag it a little bit into the center here. Hopefully I'm having success with this. Now, I'll be right back here. So I had to go locate some of my white paint here. So now I'm gonna mix up some a little bit of white. Okay, oops. There we go. That should be enough white. About 15 drops of that. And the pouring medium. Hopefully I got enough pouring medium left. I'm gonna have to buy some more. This is so addictive and fun, especially when you got two people in the family doing this. The other person that's doing this is Stephanie from Deliberately Creative, and she kind of inspired me to keep playing with this. I've seen other people's work too, and there's so many outstanding people out there that do this. So, yeah. Oh, it looks like I may just have just enough here, and I may have a little bit extra, but not much. Okay. So, I'll mix this one up. I got some more new stirring sticks, so don't want to contaminate the color here. Ah, there we go, stirring up the white. Yep. Okay, so. Okay, so now I'm gonna pour some of this in here to just to give something for my background to stick to. And there we go. Take my stick that I was stirring the white with and spread that on. I still haven't got my apron yet. But after I get this mixed up, I'll probably go get my apron. Because if I decide to spin this, or even if I flick some accidentally, I don't want to get it all in my clothes. This is so fun and so relaxing to do this art. As, you know, the abstract look is so cool. I don't know if I mixed up this white good enough in here, but hey, we'll find out. So, okay, I'm gonna go get some gloves, like I should have probably put on a long time ago, and aprons, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I'm gonna start creating my nebula. So, first I'm gonna start with my red in the center. Ooh, that should be enough. Probably too much. I think I'll add a little bit of this guy in here too. There we go. Just to the very center. And I think I will I'm going to try to use the puffer. I saw that used a couple days ago with deliberately creative trying to use that. And it was so cool looking. So now that I got that part of it done. Let's get that red back in the center, kind of. And now the last color to add on to this is the green here. That's going to kind of go on the outer edge of Nebula. And mixed in a little bit with the other green. And a little more clear, just because it looks like it needs it. I'm running low, so hopefully I haven't. My Nebby might look something completely different just because I'm running out of clear. I may have to. Okay, I think it's gonna become something else completely instead. So I'm gonna play with color. Let's see. I'm gonna make a picture here. Let's put it right there. Oops. And a spot of blues here and there. Okay, I'm just gonna double check, make sure it's kind of centered in this album. If I spin it here, I don't want it to, lose a. Well, spinning, I don't know if it's going to work for me too much right now. May have to play around later, but for now, I'm going to try mixing and blending and blending. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna have to play around with this stick, I think. And move around this a little bit. Just to cover up edges, because it seems to... not cooperate with coverage. See what happens if I add a little bit of water here and there. Oh, I think the water's just running off the edges of places. That's okay. It was an experiment. So my nebula's evolved into something else. But it's been fun learning and experimenting. And we'll see what I can do here. I'm like, wow, can you guys see that? I'm recording this with normal camera that I normally do for YouTube, but I'm also trying my phone, so maybe I can mix the two together and come up with something here with different angles of different ones. Okay, so I am going to play a little bit more here. Now I want to get that red kind of back in the middle, so I'm going to tip it all the way over the other way. Oh, I know the other camera I can't use, but I can use that one there. There we go. Okay, back on the Lazy Susan. Let's see if I can get it centered on there. There we go, just in case I can get the spin here. and then we're on the edges. Oh, this is so fun. I know I don't talk much, but hey, that's new to me. Most of my videos, I don't talk much, but I'm trying something new. I hope you guys like this process. Remember, if you like this, like, make your comments, tell me what you'd like to see more of. I do drawings also, paintings sometimes too. I'm involved with the CAC, so I do collaboration videos with, you know, with color pencils, watercolor, sometimes acrylics. And now I'm learning that the fun there is to be had with acrylic pour. So, oh wow, that is amazing. I love the colors there. And I wasn't sure if these would work because I kind of made my own mixtures of, you know, the acrylic basics with, you know, a little bit of the Flow-Aid from Liquitex and some water drops, you know, about 20 drops or so of the water to one drop or two drops of the Flow-Aid. Like I said, I got this, you know, I got really inspired so much from my wife, Stephanie, from Deliberately Creative, and other people that are also doing this. There's so many cool artists that I've seen on Let It Flow. They have a group on Facebook that does the live videos on Facebook. It's so cool. Someday I may have to try a live Facebook one, but for now, I'm just doing this here, a recorded one that I'll do some editing and share with you on YouTube. And, oh man, I'm liking the results. It may not look like my nebula, but yeah, it was an experiment. Happy experimenting here. I'm happy with this. The one thing I forgot to check to see if it was level, but I'll find out if it pours off the, if it pours off my record or not, but hopefully I got level enough. Now I'm just going to get a couple of the edges that I see that are getting a little too much black showing. If I had clear, I'd use clear, but right now I think I used the last of my clear, so I'm using the white that I made up for the edges here. This is cool. Oh, yes. This is great. Okay, now I got it all on. I'm going to play, and hopefully this is not a disaster by doing this, but I'm going to give it a whirl. Hold on to your horses. Double check my centering. Make sure nothing's going to fall off. Yeah, okay. I'll give it a small whirl and see. Okay, here we go, people. Wish me luck. Where it stops, nobody knows. One more whirl. Okay. So, wow. I think I'm happy with this. Can you guys see that? Man, oh, that is so cool. Let's see if I can get that right, but kind of closer to the center, getting a little bit mixed in there. One more time pouring that way. Just get some of that red that way. Ooh, but I don't want to lose the green that way. Ah, I think I'm going to set it down again and take a look at it again. This is great. Well, I think I'm happy enough for now. I mean, all I can do maybe is maybe a couple sprinkles of the metallic and the blue. Just a couple in that blue area there. Just get some of that metallic green. Just a couple drops here and there. Oops, I didn't want to get red, but happy little mistakes. Okay, people, hey, so I'm going to take off these gloves and move the other camera around and give you a different view, since my overhead camera is not allowing me to show you everything. Okay, so I'm going to get an overhead view and try to capture some of that. See from overhead view. Oh, maybe I'll turn off these lights here. There we go. That'll be less of the. Oh, yeah. You liking what you see in here? So here's my mess of stuff here. My turquoise color I used. My red that I used there. The white that I used. And I think I used up all of the. Yeah, and there's the metallic, the blue, the white, and I used up all my clear. So this is the final results. I hope I will do a follow up on this to add to the video when it dries to let you know how it all turned out and show you the results. I think I'm happy with this. Thanks for watching this. This has been MWB Arts, Mark B from MWB Arts. If you like this, like, subscribe, make a comment. And in the description, I'll try to make sure and cover everything that I talked about here. And thanks for joining me on my adventure. And man, I'm looking forward to creating more of this. Wow, I'm having so much fun. I'm glad I got the art bug. Thanks again. Bye.